Good afternoon, dear students. Today I am going to explain you the lesson, the second part of the lesson, A Gift of Chappals from your book Honeycomb. So in the first part we have studied about that the children were having a kitten in the backyard, in their backyard, and they were stealing sometimes milk for it, and they were taking care of the little kitten. We learned that Lali was trying to learn the music, but she did not know nothing about the music and she always was derailing. Now in the second part we see that Mridu reached the window and Lali was sitting away at a little distance, awkwardly holding violin and bowstring, her arms jutting outside. She was in a very awkward position. She was not sitting properly and not playing the violin very well. And in front of her, there was the music master's figure, very bony figure of music master. Bony means very thin. He was very thin, and he played a few notes. And Lali stumbled behind him, very unhappily, not willingly. She was seeming very tired and not playing quickly properly. Lali looked at that his huge balanced hand. Balanced means the hand bearing the ring. Balanced hand that was moving effortlessly to play the violin and creating a very lovely music. Then at the gate there was a strange sound, a strange cry, Amma, Amma, and it was the voice of the beggar. Ravi's mother was talking with his grandmother, and she spoke from behind. Ravi set the beggar away and tell him that it is the time for him. He is coming in this house from past week, and it is the time for him to find some other house and not to come here again. Ravi went there. You and Meena went after Ravi. The beggar was already in the garden and he was resting there. He was resting there under the neem tree. Ravi told the same thing that his mother said that he should find some other house for now. And at this, the beggar looked at all the three children one by one and said that the women of this house are so very kind ladies, and they have had gave me food earlier, and how I can expect them that they are sending me away. Beggar again said, Amma, O Amma, Umani again said, Ravi tell him that there is nothing left in the kitchen and he should go away and never come back again. And Ravi didn't need to say anything because the voice was directly coming from the room to the garden, and it was heard by the beggar too. That's why there was no need to repeat the line again. And then the beggar said, okay, I will go, let me do some rest. Tar has melted on the road and my feet are already blistered, so I will go. The beggar showed his feet to them, and Mridu says, whispered to Ravi and Meena that he needs something in his feet. He needs chappals. And they started finding where are the chappals. They went to find the chappals in the house. Meena was saying that it is not fair, he is having nothing in his feet and his feet are already blistered, so we should give him chappals. And then they went in the house to find out the chappals. Mridu The eyes fell on the old shabby slippers lying on the veranda, which she looked when she arrived. And she asked whose chappals are these to Ravi, and Ravi said this, yes, it is a very fine size, it is a perfect size for him, and they took the chappals to the garden. Dear students, this is all about today's lesson. We shall discuss the next part in the next video. Thanks and have a nice day.